Hi, I'm Kirby with Augustine E-Bikes. Today I'm going to share with you some e-bike maintenance tips and some e-bike tips that are going to make your e-bike a better bike to ride every day just the way we do. Oftentimes, power ratings are misleading. The problem is that manufacturers don't use the same standards to label their motors, and consumers often don't understand the differences. A watt is a unit of power named for Scottish engineer James Watt. Watts measure the instantaneous power output, or input, of a machine, such as an electric motor on your e-bike. The number of watts used by an electric motor at any moment equal the voltage supplied by the battery multiplied by the current flowing from the battery to the motor. So an e-bike motor connected to a 24-volt battery, being supplied with 10 amps of current, can be powered at 24 times 10, equaling 240 watts. Calculating the peak power of an e-bike is simple. You just multiply the voltage of the battery by the maximum current the e-bike can handle. The maximum current is determined by the e-bike's controller and is usually somewhere between 50 and 30 amps. An e-bike with a 48-volt battery and a 20-amp peak controller would theoretically be capable of a nominal 960 watts of instantaneous power. Many manufacturers underrate the bike's power for legal and shipping reasons. An example of a standard 250-watt electric bicycle conversion kit is rated at 250 watts. But looking at the specifications, you'll see the 36-volt controller has a peak current limit of 15 amps. Doing the math shows us that 36 volts times 15 amps equals 540 peak watts. This is very common in the industries. E-bikes sold with 250 watt motors often come standard with 36 volt batteries and 15 or 20 amp controllers. So a 15 amp controller would mean the actual peak power supplied by the motor is closer to 540 watts, and a 20 amp controller would be over 700 watts. The way that manufacturers get away with this is one way is to rate the motor for continuous power instead of peak power. The difference between continuous power and peak power is that continuous power essentially means the power a motor can safely handle for an indefinite amount of time without damage or overheating to the motor. A 250 watt continuous motor theoretically could run forever at 250 watts without overheating, but any more power would cause it to eventually overheat. Most of the time, a 250 watt continuous motor can handle more than 250 watts continuously, meaning the numerical naming convention is inaccurate and misleading. Limiting the wattage of e-bike motors doesn't necessarily limit how powerful they can be. Even though a motor is marked as 250 watts, anyone could connect it to a 48-volt battery and run 20 amps through the motor to achieve 1,000 watts of power. This, of course, could eventually damage and destroy the motor, but it still demonstrates how it's entirely possible from a practical standpoint.